Guys, it is absolutely cool to be with you guys today. I am getting over the flu and cold season. Was lucky enough, blessed enough to be challenged by getting the virus so early in the fall. And wanted to go ahead and talk to you about enduring suffering, the best kind. We're going to go ahead and go back to Easter if we can. I know that quite a few remember my webcast from Easter time, and we discussed the Passion of Christ. And that's basically its meaning. Its passion is enduring suffering, and it is the eternal kind. So today I am challenging everyone to go into their Bible. I know that I've been drilling into you guys how important it is to have your Bible, to have a Bible. So you are going to go ahead and look online or look in your Bible right now, whether it's electronic or physical like mine. And you're going to go ahead and go into Matthew 26 from all the way to all the parts of Matthew 26, conspiracy against Jesus, the anointing, the betrayal, the prep of Passover, the betrayer. You're going to go ahead and clearly go and read through all of the activities of Jesus, clearly into Matthew 27, from Jesus before Pilate, when Pilate was questioning him in front of the crowds, and all the way past the questioning and into the crucifixion, Jesus being handed over to the people that came for him. Into the very, very tip right before him being buried, through him being buried. And if you would like that enduring suffering from the passion all the way clearly through to the resurrection, which is Matthew 28, I want you to go ahead and read them over and over and over and over and over again. I want you to read these passages. I want them to be completely clean and clear and plain to you. The text and its contents, context, are going to need to be your clear understanding, especially if you are like me and you get sick really easily. One of the major things that happens when we get sick or when we suffer anything, when we get hurt, when someone hurts us, there's a lot of hidden material to that suffering. One, God allowing us to learn from all of that, God allowing us to be healed from all of that, God wanting us to know that the distraction of suffering and the immobilization of suffering and are doubting him in Jesus, are doubting him in the guidance and the beauty and the wonder of the Holy Spirit, are coming into our anger and injury and hatred and jealousy and other emotional feeling is, while plenty of the ways that evil tries to blind us to the realization of God. And after reading these passages in Matthew, chapters 27, 26, of course, we realize that evil is present, that we don't have to do anything to go and find it. It finds us. One, because God in Jesus, the Father, and the Holy Spirit love us and want nothing more for our good but to be able to have us recognize the reason evil blinds us with distractions about grocery lists, cooking menus, really incredible friends or really bad enemies, and so on. The list can go so far out. Evil does not want us to attain eternal bliss with Christ, with God, the Father, and the Holy Spirit, which is called heaven. And in so much of that evil wanting to perm through and, you know, butt heads with us and cause so much more pain and anger that we don't get to see joy, and we then begin to forget that there is joy in our angry and corrupt world. So we get to, in chapter 28 of Matthew and further out, we get to see good. We get to see the good that comes from pain and suffering that is obviously Jesus had to push himself to continue forward for God's plan. B, there is a plan. God has an amazing, incredible endurance plan for us. And if we don't see our challenges through, no matter how big they are, no matter how small they become, we begin to, again, forget joy and peace abounds even in chaos and anger and hurt and pain. After we've continued to fight and gone through the hardships, we can go ahead and look at Luke. Luke, chapter 2, beginning at verses 29 to 32. Now, Master, you may let your servant go in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you prepared in sight of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, in glory for your people Israel. Have a great day, you guys. And remember that there is a ton of peace and enduring beauty inside all of our challenges, pain, suffering, you name it.